Alright, welcome to another video, and before we get started, I'd like to take a quick minute to thank all the Patreon supporters and YouTube channel members whose names you see scrolling across the screen right now. They make this financially possible, and without you, I probably wouldn't be here making videos, so thank you. Alright, so in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at two new products from Radio Master that they were kind enough to send me. I just got these in the mail recently, so I haven't even opened them yet. You can see they're still both sealed in the packaging. Just want to take a quick look at them and kind of talk about what they are before we open them up and use them. First is the UART Flasher. It's basically a USB to serial tool intended to flash ELRS, Express LRS receivers. We'll go ahead and take it out of the package and kind of see what else is included with it. But basically, you would normally flash an Express LRS receiver either over the Wi-Fi access that it's built into the receivers or through your flight controller using pass-through. But sometimes that's not always possible. Maybe you just have one out on your workbench and you want to flash it, update it before you install it, make sure it works before you start soldering pins and things like that to it. And in a case like that, this is going to be quite handy. You see, you get quite the selection, actually, of different connections and things. So you get the USB tool itself. And you see it has a normal full-size USB connector on it. You have a little hardware switch here to select either 3.3 or 5 volts, like you can see there. And down here you have negative, positive, RX and TX. These are your standard, I think, 2.54 millimeter spacing on these pins. It's basically the same thing as like a servo cable that you kind of see here. That would plug right in there like that. And the other end is just your individual kind of connector. Same thing, fits like servo pin size connectors. And those can either plug directly into a receiver if you do have pins soldered on it, or you can use these little included spring locking connectors. See, there's a little pin here which will actually plug into these like so. And then if you watch right down here, when you pull this back, there's like a little spring-loaded clip that kind of grabs onto pins, like I can show you on this one here. You can grab onto a pin like that, like so, and it will hold on. Or you can also do this on the edge of a board, which I don't have handy right now. I don't have a board on my workbench without pins soldered to it, but we do have one here in the bag. I'll show you that in a minute. But yeah, you have one of each color kind of to match your wiring there. And there's also this other connector right over here, which is again negative, positive, TX and RX. And that matches these little locking style connectors here. I don't remember the name or model number or whatever these connectors, but they're included on some of the receivers, so it's handy to have that option too. You see, you can kind of plug that right in there. If we flip it over the right way, it might be more effective. But yeah, you can plug that in there, and the other end is available in some of their matching receivers. So it's going to be a pretty handy little tool. And one thing I haven't mentioned yet is you also have this little spring pin thing here, which you would kind of just plug these on. And this end is actually little spring-loaded connectors, if we can get it to focus. See, they're little spring-loaded connectors with some little sharp tips there, which is meant to plug into through holes. I really wish I had a receiver board or some kind of circuit board here on my workbench, but I just don't have one handy right now. I didn't really think I had think that through. But I will show you that in just a minute here when we open this receiver. But basically, if you have solder through holes on a board, you can just kind of hold that down and it's spring-loaded, so it keeps contact while you quickly connect to your receiver and flash it. And like I said, you would plug that on here and plug the other end into the flash tool. And so it's a pretty versatile tool. Now, I said normally you might do that instead of using the Wi-Fi or pass-through on a flight controller. Another case where this might be useful is like some of the different hardware, like my old R9 receiver that I flashed. It doesn't have Wi-Fi ability or anything like that, because it's just an old flash Tefor Sky R9 receiver, R9 MM, I think it is, the one I flashed with the LRS. But in that case, if you wanted to flash one, you could just kind of grab one of these little spring locking connectors here and grab onto the pins that are soldered to the receiver, either the pins or the wires. I don't even remember what I soldered on. It's buried down in my Dart 250 now. But you could connect those little spring-loaded clips, these ones, to the wires coming out of the receiver. You can grab onto them with that at the solder points and give you a good, reliable connection. But not only just for use with ELRS receivers, if you've been in the hobby, chances are you've probably needed a USB to serial adapter at some point already. Like, for example, this is my old one that I've had around on my workbench for a while now. This one I've used. It's actually a cable that's still plugged into it from when I was configuring a little U-Blox GPS. This one is from SparkFun, which I think is branded on the back. It's actually covered up in this glue here. As you can see, this one only had a little solder pads there to select 3.3 or 5 volts. So I actually soldered some little wires to it, put a little jumper on it so that I can select one or the other and not have it permanently selected. And it's just kind of cobbled together. It's janky, but it works. But yeah, it'll be much nicer to have this nice little tool with all the assorted connectors and things. It's going to be much, much more useful. I actually have a little project planned coming up here pretty soon. I'm going to put in my TX16S over here, my radio that I fly with. I'm going to be adding a Bluetooth adapter on here for some telemetry forwarding stuff, just kind of play around with that. So I'll actually need this to connect to that Bluetooth module and configure it before I install it in radio. So it'll be pretty useful for that. So the other item that they sent me is, well, I can show you on the back here, is the RP4TD. This is a 2.4 GHz Express LRS receiver from Radio Master. The TD in the model number is True Diversity. Radio Master's other diversity receiver is an antenna diversity receiver, which means there's one RF chip and two antennas. And they're doing some clever matching and things on board to utilize two antennas effectively on one RF chip. But by going to a true diversity receiver like this one, the difference is you have two actual RF chips. We can get out of the packaging here. You can see that. So this is the way it comes out of the packaging. You have a little selection of wire, like they always include, a little short length of silicon coated wiring to solder it up to your flight controller. You get the usual selection, three little pieces of heat shrink tubing. You only need one, but it's nice. They send you a few if you mess up or you need to change something later. You have spares. And, of course, the receiver itself. You see it comes with a 2.4 GHz dipole, center-fed dipole T-style antennas. And, like I said, importantly, the difference with this one versus the other antenna diversity receiver, if we can keep it focused here, you can see there's two actual RF chips. So you have the two oscillators, you have the two chips, the two amplifiers. It's basically two receivers packaged into one. And you might notice these other two little solder pads over here on the edge, kind of trying to keep it in focus. There's an R and a T marked on those. These are another UART, separate from the transmit and receive, the your main UART over here. There's an extra set of UART pins right there. I don't know what the intended purpose of those is at this point. I suspect it's for future development in Express LRS. Maybe some of the airport stuff or Mavlink RC stuff coming out in the future. It may be handy for that. But for now, I don't know the intended purpose of these. But it's nice that they're thinking ahead. And if we look on the other side, you see your main ESP chip down there. I think it's an ESP. Yeah, pretty sure. It's kind of hard to see it. But it's basically your typical diversity Express LRS receiver with true diversity. And these are the temperature compensated oscillators. And it's nice to see that they have two of them to go with the two RF chips and amplifiers. So yeah, and this also will support Gemini. If that's something you're interested in, being a true diversity receiver with two RF chips, you can do Gemini with this one, which is something I've never used. I don't really have the purpose for it with the kind of flying I do, but if that's your thing, it will do it. It will support it. And like I said, now that we have this out the bag, I can kind of show you the way these work. There's no through holes on this one, which makes it less than ideal to show it, but just pretend there's through holes on this little receiver board. You would just kind of seat those in through holes and then keep a little tension on them, and it just kind of keeps your good solid connection. But I think more useful for this type of little edge connectors here, you see these are edge connectors that you kind of solder to on the receiver. I think it would be more effective to use the little clip right on here. So we'll just try to keep this focused, and you kind of see that. You would grab this little clip here right onto the edge of the board right there like so, and clip that on. And now you have a good solid connection, which your wire would plug in here and go back to your serial adapter. And of course you do that on all four of them. And you see that's not really gonna go anywhere. It's, well, I guess if you shake it hard enough, it will. But yeah, it's gonna keep a good solid connection on that solder pad while you're connecting USB to your receiver. And that will allow you to connect to it and update firmware and configure it and everything. You know, get it ready, confirm that it works before you actually solder anything to it. So should you have to do a warranty claim or try to get it replaced or something like that, if it arrives dead on arrival, you can solder it up, or not solder it up, before you solder it up, you can connect it up with these and the USB tool there and flash it and check it out, make sure it's going to work and boot up and connect and everything. And if it does, then you go ahead and solder it up and install it in your drone. So like I said, this is just kind of a quick unboxing and quick look at some of this new hardware that Radio Master sent me. And I believe this is available now, and this is on pre-order, the receiver. I could be wrong about that, but if I remember right, the dates I saw, this should be available now at the time I'm uploading this video, and this will be on pre-order, but it should be available sometime this month, being December of 2023, before the end of the year. But yeah, just double check that. I'll have links to both of them. You can go check them out on their website. And once again, big thank you to Radio Master. Radio Master, we'll give them a little plug there, for sending me this stuff. And I think I'm actually going to install this receiver in the Swordfish here pretty soon. So I did recently fly it with the 900 megahertz receiver, and 915 megahertz actually, the Radio Master ELRS single antenna receiver. I kind of swapped that one out and flew with it. Now I think I'm going to put this one in and fly with it, just to play around with it and try it out. And yeah, like I said, I'll try this out, and hopefully it all goes as planned. So thank you for watching that. Keep an eye out for what's to come, and we should have some pretty interesting videos coming up here pretty soon, hopefully. And questions, comments, put them below the video, and I'll address them when I can. So thank you for watching. See you in the next videos.